Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 Beta 5 has been out for a few days, and I mentioned all of the new features and changes in the initial What's New video. But since then, there's been more that have been found, so I wanted to go over all of the additional features and changes in iOS 15 Beta 5. Now, the first thing is Apple also released HomePod OS 15 Beta 5. That's available now. That came out a little bit later. And if you have that installed on a HomePod Mini or a HomePod, you'll now have options for Dolby Atmos and Apple Lossless. Now, I don't have the beta fully installed yet on this HomePod, but if we go to Twitter, you can see Domenico actually posted this, and you can see at the bottom it says Apple Lossless and Dolby Atmos. And so it looks like those features are available if you have the beta installed. So that's really nice if you're using Apple Music. Now, the next thing is someone was asking, when you power off the phone, there's a new sort of dialogue where you can temporarily disable Find My on a device if you don't want it to find it with the device powered off. But they were asking, is that password protected? And so before we go over the other new features, we'll turn off the phone, or at least power it, get to the slide to power off screen, volume up, volume down, press and hold the power sleep wake button, and you'll see it says iPhone findable after power off. If you tap on this, you can hit temporarily turn off finding or hit OK, and we'll hit cancel for now. And you can see now it's asking for a passcode. Now, say you set down your phone, someone comes by, picks it up, and wants to take that and also disable that feature. Well, let's see if it password protects it. So if we press and hold power sleep wake, tap on it, and temporarily turn off finding, you'll see that it requires your passcode. So they can't just take it and turn off temporarily disable Find My iPhone. So it's a nice little security measure that they've put in place. Now, if we switch over to a phone that does not have an A12 Bionic or newer processor in it, or one of the older supported devices, there's a feature that's got an option that shouldn't be there, but maybe they're going to add it. So if we go to settings, under settings, if we go down to general, under general, we go down to language and region, you'll see there's an option for live text. Live text allows you to select text in images to copy or take action according to this. You'll see the button works. And if we go over to photos, what it should let us do is copy text from within photos. But if we go into photos, you'll see here's a screenshot of iOS 15 beta 4. We can tap on the image, but we cannot select text. So the option is there, but it's not allowing us to use it. So maybe Apple's trying to find a way to bring it to older phones, but technically it's not supported by anything older than an A12 Bionic. I would love to see them bring this feature there, but right now you're not able to do it. So maybe they're trying to do it. I'm not sure, but the option is there. Now, something else I found recently is if you go into notes and you use three fingers to tap, you'll get a little menu to select text or copy it. So if we tap with three fingers, you'll see at the top, it says undo, cut, copy, paste, and redo. If we go to beta 4, it's a little bit different. So under beta 4, three finger tap, you'll see that we have a different sort of menu layout. So one on the right with beta 5 has words, on the left, they're icons. So they've changed this in beta 5. So I kind of like that it explains what's going on a little bit better. So that's something that's a little bit different. Now, there's a feature that a lot of us have wanted with iOS 15 or iPhones in general for years, and that is the ability to split screen apps or use split view. And there's a shortcut that says split screen now. However, Apple sort of dashed any hope that there would be split screen because the new split screen option says this action is not supported on iPhone. With beta 4, it doesn't say this. They've added this text to explicitly say that you're not going to have split view or split screen like you do on the iPad on the iPhone. So unfortunately, it won't be available anytime soon, it looks like. But they did add that text with beta 5. Now, within the control center, if you have the options turned on, you'll have a couple new icons. Now, I mentioned one of them before, the announce Siri icon here in the bottom left, and they've been updated from beta 4 to beta 5. So you can see the exact same icons on beta 4 on the left in the bottom left and on beta 5 in the right. And you'll see that the sound recognition icon is a little bit different and the announce Siri notification icon is different. So if you tap on this, you can see sound recognition and it brings you into its own menu as well, where it brings you into the actual settings on beta 4. So it just brings you right into the sound recognition and then you can just set it up here or then go to settings by tapping on the settings icon. So it's a little bit different in this version. Now, within Safari in iOS 15, it's a little bit controversial. We have the address bar at the bottom, and there's a new setting that they've added with Beta 5. So if we go into Settings, and we go down to Safari, under Safari, scroll all the way to the bottom, go to Advanced, and then go to Experimental Features, scroll all the way to the bottom again, and you'll see that we now have the option for WebM Audio, or WebM Web Audio. This is something they've added. WebM is just another codec that's available online, and it's something that they've added in. Now, this was added with macOS a little while ago in Safari. Now it's available on iOS with Beta 5. It was turned on by default also on my device, so that's something that's new in Beta 5. Now, there's additional changes within Settings. If we go to Settings, and then we go to Focus. Under Focus, if we select a focus, so I have Home Evening, it's one that I've created. If we go to the same exact focus on Beta 4, on the left, you can see that it says Home Evening at the top, but on the right, there's a new toggle to turn it on or off. So you can turn it on or off in Settings. It's sort of a redundant setting since you could turn it off in many different places or turn it back on. And then also, Name and Appearance are new as well. So at the top here, we could tap on Home Evening before where there was no toggle. Now we have Name and Appearance in its own category. So that's something that's been updated with Focus. Also, if we go back, we'll go back to the main setting screen. And if we go down to Siri and Search on both of them, there's some changes there as well. So as I scroll down, you'll see now it has suggestions from Apple. So they've changed the wording here, and it's a little bit different. It says suggestions from Apple, and now it says allow notifications, show in app library and spotlight, show when sharing, show when listening. So they've changed some of the wording there, and also above that, they've separated it into content from Apple, where it says show in lookup and show in spotlight. So they've just made this a little bit different, where they're breaking it down to make it a little more clear as to what you're changing. Now, also within Settings, if we tap on Notifications, and then we tap on Scheduled Summary, and then we turn it on with the little switch there, we'll get a new splash screen that says Notification Summary. It explains what it is, and then we can set it up later or tap on Continue. We'll tap Continue, and it says Choose Apps for the Summary. So I'll just choose a few. We'll add two apps, and then you can set a schedule for it. So we'll turn it on. And once it's turned on, this screen is a little bit different as well from Beta 4. So if we go to the same screen on Beta 4, we go to our notification summary or scheduled summary, you'll see now we have apps and summary in Beta 4. Now it just says show next summary. So there's a toggle there that says show the next summary in Notification Center before the scheduled time. And then we have our apps below that. Prior to this, you had to tap on apps and summary, and it was a little bit different. So they've changed the way this looks. It's a little easier to interact with. Of course, you can change these with the little dial here if you tap into them. And so it's a really nice overview of how to set up scheduled summary. And I think it's a little bit better than Beta 4. Now on the iPad, some users are seeing a new notification dialog in Reminders. So if you're in Reminders, above Lists, some people are seeing a little reminder there that's showing them what they could do with Smart Lists. So someone found this and they posted it on Twitter. And on Twitter, Maxim Petrov showed this where it says, why Smart Lists? So this is what it looks like, creating Smart Lists, filtering tags, and more. So it gives more information about it. So that's a nice little feature add or a little explanation of how to actually set that up. Now in iOS 15 Beta 4, there are a couple things I didn't mention as well that I wanted to share. One of those is if you have the new smart battery pack, so if we attach this to the back, and now that it's attached, if you go into low power mode and press and hold it in the control center, you'll have the option to charge past 90%. If I remove the battery pack, this option will go away. So now you just have low power mode. So at first it didn't make sense to have haptic press here because there was nothing other than just turning it on or off that you could do with it. But as soon as you attach the battery pack and then press and hold, you have that option now. So you can charge past 90%. So that's something new as well. Also, if we go to a different website, maybe we'll go to Apple here. Within Apple, maybe we go to our control center again, and then we press and hold on the text size option or haptic press, we now have the option for Safari only or all apps. So we can adjust this in app, and we could do this before, but this was seen in Beta 4 as well, but you can adjust the text size in Safari only. So if we make it huge, go back out here, the text size should change. It has a little bit down there at the bottom where it says Apple. And if we go back in, press and hold, we can change it back, and we can apply it to all apps or just Safari only. And that's based on a per app basis. So if you want to try the same, maybe in Reminders, you can do the same. So now it's just Reminders only or all apps. We can make the text size huge, go back in, and you'll see it increased. So that's something that's a little bit different and new that was found in beta 4 as well. And the one last thing I wanted to mention is some people said that the folder animation was a little bit different in beta 5. I was not able to confirm this as I went into beta 4, did the same sort of thing, and the animation looks to be basically the same. So I'm not seeing much of a difference there, but some people are saying that it looks a little bit different. And so those are all the additional features of iOS 15 beta 5. And of course, if I find any more, I'll be sure to share them in the follow-up that I generally post on Sundays. So I do a follow-up where I cover everything from battery life to stability, performance, and your concerns based off the YouTube community poll. So I'll be posting that fairly soon as well. So look for that. And of course, be sure to check back for the follow-up if you want to see any of the issues you might be having with this or anything else that a lot of people are experiencing. So I like to cover all of those as in-depth as I can. And then I read some of the comments as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.